Hello friends, welcome to my next video tutorial of multi-stored concrete structure building analysis and design using Etabs9 program. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to insert any story and how to delete any story. So I have already done only two story, actually main one story, and I have grade beam then the base level, and I have already completed. I have done automation. I have done loading. Now I want to do more story using my this story. To do that, you have to go to here, edit, then from here edit story data, then here you can see edit story and insert story. Click here insert story, and here is some parameter you have to specify. First is story ID. The next story, say I want this should be second floor, story height should be 120, which is 10 feet. Here is the unit keeping, that so it is showing the ins. A number of history say 1, and insert above first floor level. So I have first floor level right now, and from it is asking replicate new story, so it will be similar to this first floor level. So what I have done in first floor level, it will be just copied to the next story. And if I click OK, you can see it has created another story. In the preview, you can see 3D, there is two story now. Okay. Now say if you think this second floor have some changes as per your architectural drawing or design, and you can do here, say I have a wall here or I have a beam here in this floor level, I can draw a beam here, done. So I have to select this wire and break, done. And this beam, say you have some load, just change this to pound feet, go to here, dead load say 420. Okay, done. So you have done changes in this level, which is second floor. Okay, and now you know that this will be your typical story, so you want to assign this story to the other floor level. And I have this is five story building, so I have to go to here again, edit, then edit story data, insert story, and now it is asking I am now right now in second floor, that's why it is asking second floor hyphen one. This should be say third floor, and this is 10 feet 1 above second floor from existing from the existing story second floor. So we want to make the above story similar to the second floor level. And say I have more three, I can as say here number of history 3, so it will be done at once. Okay, say done. You can see here 1 2 3 4, this is 5 story. I'm going to 3D here, just click here, show on deform shape to invisible the load. Okay, and going to here, set building view option, click here, here special effect, and check this is extrusion. Okay, this is the 3D rendered view. By going to here again and uncheck this one. Okay, and now I have already created 5-story building. And similar way, if you want to delete any story either in the intermediate level or from the top, you can do. And by going to here, edit, edit story data, you can see I have third floor and this should be fourth floor, and this is my roof level. And also from here you can change your story height name here. So some parameter you can change from here. Okay, same way, if I want to delete any story either at the intermediate level or from the top, I can do by going to here, edit, edit story data, then click here delete story. Say I want to delete third floor. Okay, so floor has been deleted. And if I want to insert any floor above the second floor, so this will be my third floor, I can do the same way, edit, edit story data, insert. From here select this should be second floor, and above second floor this is third floor, height is 10 feet. Okay, done. Another story has been added. And if you want to check, go to elevation, and you can see here this is the third floor. So we have first deleted this one and again inserted above the second floor. So this way you can insert and delete history. And from here in the roof level, when you have inserted your all story, now you have to do some additional work in the roof level, because in the roof level we don't have any wall or load on beam. So I have to change the load here on this roof level beam. And also sometimes you may have some waterproofing work above the slab, so you might have some additional dead load on the floor, then you have to assign at the roof level. And also, as I have a lift core here, stair, I have a stair room, lift, machine room, and above might have a water reservoir. So everything should be drawn here, similar to the previous floor drawing ways. So I have to draw everything here in this model above this roof level. So I will show you step by step. First, if I want to change the load from here, I have to go to here display, then show loads, frame line, this is dead load, okay. And click this perspective toggle, which is the goggles, and click this 3D rotate view and drag mouse this way. Now you can see clearly, and by clicking here this icon, you can just bigger this window. And now this is clear which wall I have load and which beam I have load and which has not. So for this beam I don't have load. Now this beam, no load. This beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, also this beam here, zero dead load on feet, this should be zero, okay. Select this beam, this line, also this beam here, this one, click here, zero, okay. Usually at the perimeter of this roof I have parapet wall loading. So if I consider 5-inch machinery wall, which should be the maximum load at 3 feet height, I can do say 3 feet 0.41 with 1 into 120, this should be so 150 pound per feet. So select this one, this is the perimeter, this one, this line, this line, this line, this line, also this line here, this line, this line, this line, this line, this line here, this line, this line. Now go here, 150 pound per feet, this is pound feet. And here in this portion I have a stair, and also here is the lift. So I have to do more study here, that's why I'm just not working on this area right now. And here I have found a problem here, this beam and this is a whole beam, but I have a beam here, so this should be divided here, this beam should be broken here and also here, because this is a joint, so all the joint of beam intersection must be broken. Go to here, second option, okay. I have to do that for the all story. I'm going to here plan, say fourth, and this beam, so I will select from here all story, select this way to be also, if it is not broken, so down, change this to 1:3. Okay, so my load change has been done. And if I go to roof, and here I have a stair room slab here, so I have to insert another story by going to here edit, insert story, this should be above roof, and this is usually 8 feet above roof. This should be a water reservoir or a stair, stair top. No, so before doing stair top, I have a machine room slab here for my lift, and this should be at 5 feet. So I'm doing this 5 feet. This is MA machine room above roof. Okay, plan and check. Yes, I am now in machine room, and here this should be 1 story. Select this way, delete this part. So I have machine room here, and I'm just inserting another story. I have this stair room slab at 8 feet, so right now I am in 5 feet. So if I go to here in insert story, and we are now in machine room slab, this should be more 3 feet and above machine room here. So if I check elevation, now you can check here, you can check this is my roof, this is my machine room level, and this should be my edit stair data, should be STA stair top. Okay, now plan here, And also above the stator I have water reservoir, and usually I have a top slab of this machine room, so that should be another 5 feet above this water reservoir level or stair top level. So if the height of this overhead water reservoir is 5 feet, then I have to insert 5 feet above the stair top level. So go to here, edit, insert story, stair top. This should be another 5 feet, and this should be above stair top. Okay, done. And now from here I have, this is my lip room, assign a slab, take this option, say 5, select this one, this one, this one, this one. Okay, delete this portion from this top, I don't need anything here. And the machine should be extended and almost 4 feet here, so I don't want to extend anymore, this will work. And now I have to change this slab, this one, this one, this one, everything should be 5 inches. Selecting this one, I have to go to assign, shell area, wall slab, 5. Okay, so all are 5 now. And the beam size I have to change here. We have not mass load here, so we can change this beam. This is the topmost level of my building here, and here is only this slab load will be acting on this beam. That's why there is no additional wall load here. So I will change this size to, say, going to here, assign frame section, add rectangular, say be 10 divided by 12, should be B3, depth is 1, 1, this should be 0.833. from here beam, this is say 1.6, 1.6, this should be 2.2 for 2.5 inches a clear cover. Okay, okay. And be 10 12. Okay, so my beam size has been changed from here. And if I want to check load here, I have to go to your display, then shell area, dead load 25, select this one, assign load, dead load should be 25, and select this one, go to here, auto mesh, done. And a live load of, say, another 20 psf will work. Live load, say 20, done. And check display, this load. So I don't need to assign too much load here. Delete this. This one. 0. And here, if I have any parapet wall loading, then I have to assign here, say this should be 2. If I consider 2 feet, this should be 100 pound for feet dead load. Okay, done. So my, this floor is done. So this is my plan. This startup I have to change, go to edit, edit history. This should be the top of my this building. Okay, now change plan to startup, go to startup. In startup I have nothing here. Yeah, this should be related this way. Okay, so here will be my water reservoir load on this slab. So this slab should be in my requirement minimum 6 inches. So select this one, assign here 6. Okay, and the load will be, dead load is 25 psf. Okay, and I have water reservoir load. So if I have I have total height 5 feet, clear height should be approximately 4.5 feet. And if I consider another 6 inch freeboard, so the load of the height of water will be 4 feet. So 4 into 62.5 is unit weight of water, so the load will be 250. This will be as live load. So select this slab, assign here live load 250 for water weight. Okay, and at this perimeter I have 6 inch concrete wall load. As I am constructing water reservoir here, so above this stair top I have 6 inch thick concrete wall. So I have to assign load here, and this will be along this wall, this beam, and this beam, also this beam. So I have deleted this beam. I have to continue this beam up to here. So I will select this beam, this beam, this beam, and this beam, and I have load here for 6 inch concrete wall. So the height should be total 5 minus 1 foot beam at the top, 4 feet into 0.5 is thickness into 1 into 150 is the unit weight of concrete, so 300 pound per feet. So dead load, this should be 300 done. If you check this way, this portion, and here I have nothing above this. I'm not extending my water reservoir at this extended part because I have stair just below this. That's why I'm not deleting this slab. I will decode this slab to cover the bottom stair. So this should be zero load. Okay, done. And I have added 300 pound per feet for my concrete wall. So this is my stair top. Go to the bottom. Here, this is my machine room, which is the 5 feet from the roof level. And as per the requirement of your local country or the procedure of your local building construction and LEED requirement, then you have to draw your roof level or machine room level and other level as per your country code or country requirement. And this is my country requirement, that's why I am doing this way. And you can do any other way following my this procedure. Now here, this is my machine room top, so I will delete. I don't need anything here for stair, and I don't need this one, and I have to delete this slab also, all this beam. I need this. Here is a slab, and this should be 8 or 9 inch, so I will do this is 9 inch. Select this, go to here shell area object auto mesh, then okay. Select this one, and for my machine room I have a machine weight here, which is approximately 250 pound per feet, and this is as per the code requirement. As per your code requirement and weight of machine, this might be different for your design. So select this slab, assign uniform load, this should be 250 live load. Select again, assign, this is dead load to 25. Okay, now check, there is no load, but there will be some load here because I have this machine room height almost 8 feet, so I have almost 3 and 5, so 8 feet. So 8 feet, if I have 8 feet machinery wall, 8 feet into 0.415 means weight, then 1 feet, then 120, so almost 400 pound per feet machinery weight on these three beams. So I have selected this three beam. Go to have this icon, dead load, this should be say 400 pound per feet. Okay, done. And select this beam, the load should be zero here. Okay. So now if you check again carefully, you can see this is my roof, and at 5 feet, this is my machine room, and there will be machine for the lift operation. And above that, I have at 8 feet, this is my water reservoir bottom, or this is my stair room top slab, and the next one is the hole. I have the this is the top, so this part will cover the water reservoir and this part will cover the machine room. So by mistake I have deleted here, there will be a slab too. So I will assign a slab here, and this part will be cantilever slab from this, so no problem, I can just mark this one and again break this one. Because if I go to right, if I right click on, and you can check the load here, all the load has been assigned here due to merging and dividing again. So I don't need to add another, but I have to assign some load here because null line here. Select this two, and I have almost 8 feet height above this, so I have assigned almost 400 pound load previously, so this should be here. Okay, done. Here will be load, here will be load this one. So this is the procedure of inserting history, deleting history, and also editing history. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching my this video, and see you in the next video.